Hi, my name's Greg. I'm Business Development Director here at Jellyfish, and today I'm going to talk to you a bit about how we approach PPC specifically, and also go into more detail about our methodologies and what we do behind the scenes in order to achieve success, I guess, through PPC. Now, unlike manufacturing, for example, economies of scale don't really apply when it comes to PPC, unfortunately. And ultimately, the more volume you try and achieve, the more expensive it will end up becoming. And the best way to visualize this is to look at, if we imagine a curve, a cost curve, we call it. So if you look at it on the screen here, you'll see that on the left-hand side, you've got your CPA and your volume running along the bottom. The more volume you try and achieve, ultimately that curve will become steeper, and it will become a point where no matter how much money you spend in the networks, you won't be able to achieve any more volume. Now, the idea or what we try and do as an agency is obviously shallow that curve so that you're achieving more volume for the same cost per acquisition target. So if you look here, we can see that the curve is shallowing. So through use of our campaign methodologies, we can actually drive more efficiency through the campaign and basically, you know, make your spend work for you and maximize the return on investment you're getting. So the methodologies we use in order to shallow that cost curve is all based around our cost per acquisition metrics tree. Now, this is trademarked by Jellyfish, and we've been adopting this approach for well over 10 years now, and it's all stemmed from us having a heritage as a performance-based agency. So when we're working with our clients, we understand that for the majority of clients, they're all trying to achieve some sort of cost per acquisition target within their paid media spend, whether that be a cost per lead or an acquisition or a subscription, for example. So if we're fixing that cost per acquisition target, what we understand is that there's various different metrics that make that cost per acquisition. And if we see on the screen here the cost per acquisition metrics tree, you can see all of the different metrics that end up or result in your cost per acquisition. So we've got your impressions times your click-through rate. They'll give you the amount of clicks you're getting on your campaign. If you times your average cost per click by your clicks, then obviously that gives you the amount that your campaign's costing you. Similarly, on the other side, you've got your clicks times your conversion rate will get you your total number of conversions. And then essentially divide those two figures by each other, and that gets you your CPA. Now, what we need to do when we're managing campaigns is positively affect these metrics in order to, you know, achieve the CPA and get as much volume as we can within that CPA. Now, there's only four of those metrics that you can actually directly affect through campaign management. The other metrics, which are shown in a different color, they're all symptoms of affecting those metrics. Now, I guess a common misconception within paid search is that it's all about bid management, and although bid management is a massively important component of that, actually increasing and lowering bids isn't the only thing you should be looking at in terms of driving efficiency through campaigns, and in some instances is actually the last thing you should do. So if we look on the screen here, you can actually see that there's well over 20 different things that you can do to affect these different metrics, and they range from, you know, increasing your bid caps and lowering your bid caps, obviously as discussed, but also looking at things like the amount of keywords you've got in your keyword portfolio, ad copy qualification and dequalification, so making your ad copy more attractive and driving more volume through it and actually making it more qualified, so reducing the amount of people that are likely to click on your ad, and a whole host of other things. And I guess what's key to say here is that actually looking at those on an ongoing basis every day is very labor intensive, and it requires a big team behind the scenes that are actually looking at these, but also a sophisticated technology that's able to look at this data and place it in an environment that means that PPC managers can actually make educated decisions. So our bid management platform, which is a proprietary tool developed within the Jellyfish group, puts all of the keyword data, it pulls it through APIs, into dynamic keyword portfolios so that our PPC managers can make accurate bid management decisions in order to hit your target CPA and target conversion rate and ultimately drive as much volume as possible and return on investment. Now, those portfolios are split into two different types. We've got converting keywords and also non-converting keywords. And first we're going to talk about the non-converting keywords. So if you look at this dynamic portfolio, the image on the screen here, you'll see that you've got your target CPA on the left-hand axis, and your target conversion rate along the bottom. Now, what we're saying here, what the system is highlighting to the PPC managers, is that the keywords that are in that bottom left-hand corner are the ones that you don't need to pay too much attention to at this stage. Now, they haven't had a lot of traffic and they haven't spent a lot of money. So what that means is that essentially, there isn't enough data at that point in order to make an educated decision as to whether or not those keywords are going to add value to your campaign. As you see, as those keywords start to gravitate towards your targets that you've set, so your target CPA and conversion rate, that's when you really need to start investigating why those keywords haven't converted for you. Because at that point, they have actually spent a fair amount of money and they have received enough data for you to actually genuinely decide whether or not those keywords are worthwhile having in the account. So that's when you would look at things like, you know, is your cost competitive? Is your conversion on-site conversion working correctly? You know, does it need to be improved? And essentially, if at that point you can't improve that keyword's performance, it will then move into the far side of this diagram, which at that point is exceeded your target cost per acquisition and your target conversion rate. And essentially, at that point, remove the keywords from the portfolio because they are actually wasting campaign your budget, basically, and they're being detrimental to the campaign. So if we look at the converting keywords, if you see you can see here that the diagram is very similar, but this time it's split into four quadrants essentially. So in the bottom left-hand corner, again, you've got your cost per acquisition on the left-hand side and your conversions along the bottom. Now, the keywords in the bottom, again, similar to the non-converting keywords, these are the ones that you don't need to pay too much attention to because although they're not converting very well, they're actually not spending a lot of money either. So again, they probably haven't had enough traffic at that point to really make a proper decision on whether or not they're adding value. If we look at the square above that, these are the alerts. So pretty self-explanatory in what it's saying. You know, you're alerted to these keywords because actually those keywords are spending a lot of money and they're not converting very well. So unless there's a really obvious reason as to why that's the case, those are the keywords that you need to think about reducing the bids on. And if they continue not to perform, that potentially remove them from the account if you haven't got any sort of attribution data to say that they're assisting elsewhere, other conversions. On the far side of the diagram, we've got the investigate quadrant. Now, this quadrant's interesting because these keywords are actually spending a lot of money. They're coming in over your target CPA, but unlike your alerts, they're actually converting very well. So where an automated system, for example, might be working to set bid parameters and so on, it might, in this instance, lower the bid on those keywords. And we've done extensive testing, and actually, by lowering the bid on these keywords in order to try and bring them more in line, you can actually have a detrimental effect on the campaign in terms of volume because of the way in which they drop off the landscape. So the key thing here is actually, although those keywords are coming in over CPAs, is understanding why and looking, if we go back to the, or remember back to the CPA metrics tree I was talking to you about earlier on, looking at all of those different things such as ad copy qualification, dequalification, your landing page, is the keyword going through to the right landing page, for example, and really understanding, you know, why are those keywords costing more money than they should? Before you make the drastic change of just lowering the bid. And then the last quadrant, or the last part of that quadrant, is the bottom right-hand corner one, which is, again, relatively self-explanatory. These are your opportunities. So these keywords, they're not in position one, which is why they're being shown here. And if you look, they're converting very well, and they're not spending enough, well, not spending a lot of money. So what they're essentially coming in under your target CPA. So in that instance, increase the bid because those keywords, they may be in position 4 or 5 and there's an opportunity there to increase the bid on those keywords, get them further up the landscape. Ultimately, they'll get more traffic and hopefully if they continue with the same level of conversion rate, then they'll drive more volume for you. If we look at the next image here, the idea through what we do in terms of campaign management with the assistance of this technology is that we're trying to gravitate those keywords to that central point, which is your target cost per acquisition and your target conversion rate. Now, you know, unfortunately, it's never the case that you can get all those keywords into that central point. But the key is that with this technology, what it's doing is it's constantly trying to push those keywords towards your targets so that you're consistently driving efficiency through the campaign. And if we go back to that, you know, first image I showed you about the cost curve, ultimately, all of those efforts are helping to shallow that curve so that you or your media spend is working for you and you're getting the best return on your investment. So one last thing I just want to talk to you about is once all these conversion metrics are in place and you're managing the campaign is about testing. You know, it's an ongoing thing here at Jellyfish and it's ingrained into everyone's approach that you test, analyze and refine. And it's really important to do this on an ongoing basis in order to make sure that your campaign is as efficient as possible and driving you the absolute maximum volume that you can possibly get. So thanks for watching. I hope that's given a bit more insight into how Jellyfish approach PPC in particular. Of course, if you want to find out any more information, we can go into a lot more depth. So please don't hesitate to give us a call and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks very much.
Position all right?
Yep, perfect.
Hair looking good?
All good. Go for it.